divine rules for sparing our lives. The Bible says it is not by might or power, but by His Holy Spirit. So we congratulate ourselves today to the glory of God. I want to thank the Lord for letting us see this day. Shall we stand up and shout seven and the news to praise the Lord? In Exodus chapter 20 verse 12, it says, honor your mother and father, that your days may be long upon the land which the Lord is giving you. There is a promise there. My sermon is titled, Respect. Psalm 3, Proverbs chapter 22,
verse 22
to 23.
And do not despise your mother.
Can you stop again, please?
Listen to your father who begot you, and do not despise your mother when she is old. Buy the truth, and do not sell it. Also, wisdom and instruction and understanding. The father of the righteous will greatly rejoice, and he who begets...
Listen to your father who begot you, and do not despise your mother when she is old. All children here, you need to listen to your fathers as they are the head of our home, as Christ is the head of our church. You should not disrespect your mother because she held you in your womb for 9 months and is still taking care of you. Buy the truth and do not sell it. Also wisdom, instruction, and understanding. Children, you need to be honest with your parents and do not let your peers who have no discipline contaminate what you know is right and expected of you. May the Lord bestow His wisdom, knowledge, and understanding unto us.
Amen.
You should also listen to the instruction of our parents. As I have been told many times, remember the child of who you are. Run to Omar and T.E. Wanshe. Can someone please read Leviticus chapter 10, verse 1 to 3.
10 verse 1. Then Nadab and Abihu, the son of Aaron, each took his censer and put fire in it, put incense on it, and offered propane fire before the Lord, which he had not commanded them. So fire went out from the Lord, and devoured them, and they died before the Lord. And Moses said to Aaron, this is what the people spoke, saying, by those who come near me, I must be regarded as holy, and before all the people, I must be glorified. So Aaron held his peace, and the Moses called Mishael and Elzaphan, the son of Uzziel, the son of Aaron, and said to them, come near, carry your brethren from before the sanctuary.
You can stop, please. Nadab and Abihu wanted to burn incense, but because they didn't use the special fire that was instructed of them, God killed them. This is similar to when your parents punish you for disobeying them. Like when my parents told me to come home early, but I want to stay out a little bit longer. And when I eventually get home, I will then get punished. With all due respect, this is also directed towards the adults. Because when the sermon is preaching and speaking the word of God, you will be talking. Throughout the whole service, you will be walking up and down and talking. It says up here, the Lord is in His holy temple. Let all that is on earth keep silence before Him. You do not like it when your children disobey you. So how do you think when you are constantly disrespecting God? It is my prayer that you should be respectful in everything we do. And it is because God is in control that the sermon for this year's juvenile harvest is about respect. Respect means to obey, to honor, to help, to listen, and to support. We should all do these things to our parents and also to our neighbors. Jesus loved us so much that he gave us his life for the salvation of our souls. And someone please read Mark 9, 33 to 37.
Then he came to Capernaum, and when he was in the house, he asked them, "What was it you disputed among yourselves on the road?" But they kept silent, for on the road they had disputed among themselves who would be the greatest. And he sat down and called the 12 and said to them, "If anyone desires to be first, he shall be last of all, and servant of all." Then he took a little child and set him in the midst of them. And when he had taken them in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever receives one of these little children in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but him who sent me."
Reading through the lessons for today, it's my understanding that it teaches us respect, whether young or old. Respect is reciprocal. Looking at Mark 9, it tells us that if we lack respect, we're not deserving of any form of responsibility or leadership, as Jesus explained to his disciples. A wise child will know how to respect, because in the wisdom in him, he teaches to be respectful to all around him. Parents will be proud of them, because the child listens and does the right thing. Can someone please read Luke chapter 15, verse 14 to 22.
But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in that land, and he began to be in want. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that. Then he country, and he sent him into his fields and fed wine, and he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him. But when he had paid himself, he said, "How many of my father's high servants have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father and will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.' And he arose and came to his father. But when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven, sight, and I'm no longer worthy to be called your son.' But the father said to his servant, 'Bring out the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, on his feet, and bring the fattened calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry.'"
You can stop now. The prodigal son got a second chance after sinning, and his father forgave him. Some people didn't get that second chance because they didn't respect their parents. When we repent of our bad ways and honor God as we should, God is prepared to take us back unto himself. But it's better for us not to learn our hard way, like the prodigal son, because it is good to be under the shadows of his wings. It is my prayer that God will not reject us in Jesus' name. Amen. Shall we sing hymn 620?
Thank you.
phrase about humility, patience, perseverance, fear of God and man, blessings, peace of mind, happiness, joy, and many other things. I hope that what I have said today has changed your heart to make you a better person. In conclusion, you must obey, respect, and honor everyone. I pray that the Lord will honor and make our new country in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ.